Culture Vlog. Episode 3, Louis XIV, Louis the Sun King. Legend has it that Louis was pretty hot. Or maybe not. Have the movies been lying to us? Most actors who play him turn out to be total babes. He had sparkling blue eyes, an aquiline nose, and was a dancer. Conversely, he lost his hair, some teeth in the roof of his mouth, and suffered from gout. Writers of the time say he was handsome, exquisitely polite, and charismatic. I highly recommend reading the memoirs of Madame de Montespan, his number one mistress. And there were quite a few others. So we'll look at some portraits and decide for ourselves. I think we'll need to go to Versailles for this. The royal collections hold a treasure trove of Louis, chronicling his entire life. The Bibliothèque Nationale has over 700 engravings of the king, the best by Robert Nantui. He was able to sketch the king over 12 times from life. The engravings were completed in a workshop from pastel study. Because I don't find this portrait particularly hot, we'll just have to skip Hyacinthe Rigaud and the greatest portrait of him ever made. For these lovely coins made by the medalist Jean Waron, bas-relief sculptors took great care to create an icon of fidelity and a strong likeness on a very small scale. Louis's visage was put to coin and currency throughout his whole life. Jean Waron was the first sculptor and director of the Royal Mint, so we can trust his likeness. Waron actually met Bernini when he came to sculpt this icon of Louis, which took 5 months. There's a story in a Numanism guide where Waron actually seeks Bernini's approval after seeing this amazing sculpture. This was recorded because when Bernini was working, he was surrounded by French nobles who were critiquing every move he made. Bernini had another commission. It was a monumental sculpture of the king on horseback. The king didn't like it when he received it. This terracotta maquette gives us an original idea of Bernini's intention. Louis asked the artist François Girardon to change the sculpture into a Roman general. Back to Waron, this is the way he sculpted a bust of Louis before meeting Bernini. And after, Waron created this full-length monumental sculpture of the king with wind blowing through his hair and rock-hard Roman abs. True testament to how artists inspire and change each other's work. And for my final vote of hot, I'll leave you with this portrait by Charles Le Brun, who was Louis's chief painter. He wound up painting all of the likenesses of Louis in the Hall of Mirrors when you look up at the ceiling. It's just a beautiful painting.